Hi, my name is Monica and today I am going to discuss a very important topic, which is permission in Jira Cloud, and this is my favorite topic as well. A Jira admin have to set the permissions on the instance level, on the project level, and on the issues level as well. So for a Jira admin, it is a very necessary to understand the permissions very well. Before going forward, we will see what is the agenda of this video. In this video, we will learn what are the permissions and the types of permissions in Jira. What are the permissions in Jira? So permissions are basically settings in Jira applications, and with the help of the permission, we can control what users can see and do within the Jira applications. We can set the permissions in the Jira applications as per our requirements or business need. Now we will see types of permissions in Jira. So in Jira, we have three types of permissions. First one is a global permission, project permission, and the issue security permission. We'll see what is global permissions. So these permissions apply on whole application, means global permissions are system wide, not for the individual. And we can grant the global permissions to group of users only. If you want to change the global permissions, you must be a Jira admin or a site admin. It means if you are not a Jira admin or a site admin, you cannot change the global permissions. Next, we will see the project permissions, and this is a very important permissions that a Jira admin use on a day-to-day basis. Project permissions are created within permission schemes, which are then assigned to specific projects by Jira admins. So you can see I have used a term permission scheme. So what is this? The permission schemes, I'll tell you in my next videos, because in my next videos I am going to cover the global project and the issue security schemes separately. This video is just about the introductions, what are the permissions, what type of permissions we have in Jira, and what are the meaning of these permissions. So let's come back to the project permissions. Okay, so project admins can assign users to a project. They can't customize the permission schemes for a project. It means if you want to change the permission schemas, then the Jira admin only can change it, but the project admins only can assign the users to a project with the help of the project role. We have lots of permissions for the project level, where we can set to control what users can do within the project. With the help of the project permission schemes, we can set the permissions of the users, and we can make a boundary for them, what they can do, what they can see in our project. So this is a very important permissions. Now, the third one is a issue security permissions. As you can see in the name is issue security, it means the permission which will help us to set the security for a issue is called issue security permissions. This permission organized into security schemes. These allow the visibility of individual issues to be adjusted. You can create the issue security labels within issue security schemes and set the visibility of the issue. The Jira Cloud admin only can change the issue security level. It means if you want to change the issue security permissions, you must be in a Jira Cloud admin role. So these are the three permissions that I have explained to you, which is global, project, and issue security permission. It is just an overview. In my upcoming videos, I'll cover one by one. Now we will go our Jira Cloud instance and we will see how can we access the global permissions, where we can see the project permissions and the issue security permissions as well. This is my Jira Cloud instance, and first of all we will see where we can see the global permissions. You can see we have our options here, which is a setting or a coke icon. We'll click here and then we will go to this Jira setting, which is system. In the system Jira setting, when you will come here in the left side menu, you can see we have a global permission under the security. We will click in the global permission and it will open a global permission page. Here you can read the little bit informations about the global permission, like these permissions apply to all projects and they are independent of project specific permissions. and these are the global permissions here. So in this video, I'll not cover these permissions. The global permissions will be covered in my next video, which will be completely dedicated for the global permissions. I'll talk more about the global permissions and these permissions as well in my next video. Now we will go and see where we can see the project permissions and the issue security permission. For that, we will go again to the setting icon and we will click on the issues. Now you will scroll down and in the issue attributes, you can see we have the issue security schemes, notification schemes and the permission schemes. I'll cover the notification schemes in this series only because this is also a very important schemes which we used on the day-to-day basis. Now you can see we have the issue security schemes and the permission schemes here. We will click on the issue security and right now I have created a issue security scheme. It's just only for the testing purpose. If you want to add your own security scheme, then you can simply click and it will open a new window which will ask you about the name and the descriptions of the security schema. Now we will go back to the issue security scheme and it is telling you a little bit about the security scheme. Issue security scheme allow you to control who can and cannot view the issue. They consist of a number of security level which can have users, groups and assigned to them. So I'll cover the issue security scheme in the upcoming videos and definitely we will create a new issue security scheme. We will create the level and we will assign these levels to the security schemes and we will play with this security schemes. Now we will see the permission scheme. When we'll click on the permission scheme, then it will open a permission scheme page and it is telling you like permission scheme save your time in a project setup and admin and each scheme is set of permissions that you can apply to the multiple projects. So here we have the few default permission schemes, which is default permissions scheme and the default software scheme. What is the default permission scheme? So default permission scheme means when you will create a new project, then this particular default permission scheme will be assigned to that newly created project. So this is the default permission scheme. You can create your own or you can use this one as well. And if you want to create your own and want to make them to default one, then you can do it as well. So I'll cover these things later in the series. Right now I have told you the permission scheme here. Now you have a question in your mind, where is the project permission scheme? So if you want to see the project permission scheme, then you will go to the particular project into the project setting and you will be able to see the project permission scheme there. Now let me show you. I'll use the sample scrum project and in the left side sidebar we will click on this project setting and when you will scroll down we have this permission section here. You will click on this permissions and here we are. You can see this particular sample scrum project is using default software scheme. So like this, if you want to see which projects is using which permission scheme, you can simply go to the project setting and you can click on the permissions. I hope now you are able to understand what are the permissions, what type of permissions we have in Jira. And let me summarize, like we have the three permissions in Jira, global project and the issue security permissions. And permissions are nothing, like permissions are just a setting in the Jira applications which give us the facility to control what the users can see, what the users can do. That's all for this video. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, then please hit the like button, subscribe this channel and please ask your questions into the comment box. Please share this video to the other person so that they can also learn the permissions in Jira. Thank you for watching this video. Thanks.